Miss Selina Phiri. So, I'll take you in English, and our topic for today is writing. Under writing, we'll discuss adverbs. We are going to discuss adverbs. What did you learn last time in English? Okay, you learned about the prepositions. You learned about the preposition and partly you learned about adverbs. So I just want to continue from where you ended. So what did we say adverbs are? What is an adverb? So we are saying an adverb is a word that tells us more about a verb. An adverb is a word that tells us more about a verb. Any word that tells us more about a verb is an adverb. Meaning it describes the verb. It gives more details about it, the verb. It gives more details about the verb. Since we are saying an adverb tells us more about the word, a verb. An adverb tells us more about a verb. So today we will look at something else. We are going to look at the words we use. Words we use to replace, we are saying one word for many. So one. What do I mean here? So instead of using maybe a lot of words, but we replace those words by one word. Instead of using a lot of words in a sentence, but those words can be replaced by one word. This is what we are calling one word for many. One word to stand in for many words. But in as far as that word is, as we replace the words, the meaning of the sentence should not change. So we are saying sometimes we can replace a group of words. Sometimes we can replace a group of words within one word. We replace a group of words within one word. But the meaning still remains the same. So we are saying we can replace, we replace a group of words within one word. Instead of us to have a long sentence, we can replace those words by one word. Or we can replace those words within one word. So that's what we're going to discuss. So for example, we have an example here. She wrote in a neat way. So now, since we are saying that we want to know how to replace a word with one word. So here we have, she wrote in a neat way. Which word, can you tell me the words that we can replace here, and which words can we put in place of these words that we have? Words. Instead of using these words, she wrote in a neat way. Because we have lot of words in this sentence. So now we want to get rid of some words. So which term can we replace and maintain the same meaning of the sentence? Very good. We are going to say, she wrote neatly. Blessed in a neat way. In a neat way. We have replaced them by just one word. So we have replaced these words in a neat way with just one word, neatly. She wrote neatly. She wrote neatly. We've gotten rid of whom? These words. Is it clear? So instead of writing she wrote in a neat way, you can simply say she wrote neatly. We are going to have another example. Remember, the meaning has not changed. The meaning is still the same. When you are replacing words, make sure the meaning remains what? The same. The meaning has not changed here. So we are going to have another example. Okay, so we have another example. Who can read for us the sentence? Who can read the sentence? Very good. So here we have, we go out to play every day. We go out to play every day. So we want now to change this, to get rid of some words, and replace them by just one word. Instead of saying we go out to play every day. Who can tell me how we are going to replace the word or our answer here? How are we going to write the sentence? How are we going to write the sentence? Very good. So our sentence will be, we go out to play daily. We go out to play daily. We go out to play daily. So we've gotten rid of this word every day. We've gotten rid of the words every day. Or rather, the words every day. Every and the other words day. We've gotten rid of them. And then we have the sentence here. We go out to play daily. We go out to play daily. Has the meaning changed? Has the meaning of the sentence changed? No, the meaning is still the same. It's talking about you going out to play every day. We go out to play daily. Are we together? Is it clear? So the meaning should not change. The meaning should not change. All we are doing here is to get rid of some words and replace them by just one word, and still we maintain the same meaning of the sentence. We have the last example. We are going to have the last example. So pay attention. You pay attention. You pay attention. we have another example. We have another example. Who can read for us? Who can read the example? Very good. The children ate their lunch without any noise. The children ate their lunch without any noise. So can you tell me the words that we are going to replace here? Can you tell me the words that we are going to replace without changing the meaning of the sentence? We are talking about children eating without making noise. The sentence is saying the children ate their lunch without any noise. So how are we going to replace some words here? I'm still making the sentence, the meaning of the sentence. Or can you tell me the word which will replace some words here in and maintain the same sentence? Very good. Quietly. Very good. Quietly. So we are going to replace some words in this sentence. We'll replace without any noise. Without any noise. Without any noise. So these three words will be replaced by one word. So here we say, any difficulty. You choose a word here then you replace. You got the question 4. We will finish our homework in a short time from now. We will finish our homework in a short time from now. Here where it is written answer, you do the same. You replace these words in a short time from now. You replace with only one word. And that way you are going to get it, you choose from the table. You go to question 5. King Ashoka ruled the country in a wise manner. King Ashoka ruled the country in a wise manner. Here we have written answer. You write this sentence, then you replace these words in a wise manner, just with the one word. And where are you going to get the words? From the table. Is it clear? Thank you very much. This is Miss Phiri from Fountain. I teach grade 4. Thank you. Have a good day.